there's a bunker, it's surrounded by minefields, barbed wire, okay? So, I want you to look at the most outstanding white village, just in the valley, yeah? It's not a village, it's a United Nothing base, because they are monitoring the buffer zone between Israel and Syria. Okay, guys? So, look at the United Nations base. Are you all with me there?
Mm-hmm.
Good. Go to our left, to the end of the last houses, yeah, of this military. There is an empty area, then there is another few houses, white houses. Near, to the right-hand side, attached to the right-hand side of the few houses, you can see like a highway going up.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. See it? Yeah. It's not a highway. You are looking at an anti-tank trench, barbed wires, minefields, and the white one, patrol road. This is the ceasefire line. It comes from there. It comes to the United Nothing area. It makes an L shape, 90 degrees, to our left, and it goes through or near before a ghost town. Why do I call it ghost town? Nobody lives there, you see? With the many trees. Puneitra, it's the name Puneitra. You can see it on your maps later on. It goes actually between us and Puneitra. Now, to see it better, you see the water reservoir, not the big one, the small one over there. Water, like a pool, yeah? Just behind it, you can see the border, which comes from there. And it goes beyond what looks like a tail, okay? And beyond, it climbs up to the village over there, you see? This is a new Puneitra, the people who deserted the village in the war. Neglected it, left it, and moved it, and to build their new Puneitra inside there. Clear? The border goes near there, and it goes beyond the windmills, beyond, and it goes all the way to the stone quarry. Do you see the stone quarry over there?
Yeah.
And then it climbs up Mount Hermon. Good? Whatever you see behind the line that I showed you is Syria. You're looking at Syria. For example, the water reservoir, the big one, yeah? In Syria, all the villages, Syria, all, of course, Puneitra, Syria, all near the quarry, yeah? Syria. Okay, guys? This is the ceasefire between Syria and Israel. Now, are you ready? I promise shortly we'll do it, okay? But we need to blah blah a little bit about the wars of Israel, shall we? Up till 1967, I showed you where the Syrians were. They were actually near Tel Dan, you remember? Not only on the mountain, not only on the Golan Heights, but down in the slopes there, clear? Within the last 2 days of the Six-Day War, day five and this day six, the Jewish settlers from the Jordan Valley, from the Hula Valley, near Dan, okay, Daphna, all those kibbutzes, begged the Israeli government, you have the momentum. Within the last 4 days, you conquered an area which is 3 times the size of Israel, Sinai Peninsula, huge area that we gave up to Egypt for a piece of paper, for peace. Yeah. You conquered all the West Bank, including East Jerusalem, including Mount of Biad and Mount of Olives. Please help us. They're harassing us for the last 19 years. Take them over, do away with them. And the government, at last, said, okay, within 2 days. This was a miracle war. 2 days, they conquered the 7 most important percentage of Mount Hermon, okay? And the most strategic one, and the Golan Heights. Everything within day 5 and 6 of the 6 day war. If this is not America, I don't know. Beloved, would not feel you would not find yourself in euphoria.
Wow.
But instead of giving God the honor that is due only to him, let me bring you back to the book of Deuteronomy. Where is Rabbi Yisroel? Deuteronomy. When I give you the land, I give you houses that you don't build, vineyards that you don't plant, etc. You know these verses. And I let you win against all your enemies. Never say, look at me, Kochi ve'otzer yadi, my power, my arm did it for me. Beloved, make sure that others can go. Thank you. Never, you know, give the honor to me. Okay, guys? What happened immediately at the close of the Six-Day War? Are you ready? It's our pilot. It's our this. Yeah. 6 days, it's so clear that it's a miracle. We tripled the size of Israel within 6 days, beloved. We redeemed Jerusalem after 2,000 years. 2,000 years without the Western world. Mount Moriah, yeah? And we are there. And what do we say? Oh, it's our perfect pilots. It's this, it's that, but not God. Guess what? What would you do to your son when he gets to almost teenage and he says, I don't need you. You know, all that I do is because of me. If you're a good parent, and today you would be put in jail, you know, you would spank, right? You would say, Adam, don't worry, it's not you, Adam, I just can't get it. Adam, go to your room. You know, and while doing it, you will take your belt, go to your room, and wait for me, please, with your underpants. Today, I told you, today it would be considered abuse, and they would put me in jail. Who cares? I care for the Bible. Discipline your son. Are you with me? Guys, God sees that they did not give homage to him. They did the opposite of what say to them in Deuteronomy. And you know what he does? Israel, my son. You know, Israel is called God's firstborn son. Remember, Moses is sent to free my firstborn son, Israel, yeah? Friends, Israel misbehaved like Adam. God says, like saying in the heavenly, while opening his belt, go to your room and take your trousers. I want it with your underpants. Are you ready, beloved? 6 years pass, 1967 to 1973. According to my bad math, it's 6 years. 6 years it took God to take the belt out and to come to Adam or to Israel's son. We talked about, wait for me with your underpants, Day of Atonement, 1973. Ask every Jew. We fast there with no brushing of teeth. There is no fast like the Westernized invented fast on Jews. Or fast, you know, only from your ice cream. No. Fast is fast. You don't eat nor drink 25 hours to 26. Before sunset to after sunset. Are you with me? You know what is the most difficult time in the fast? Around 2 o'clock, 2 p.m. of the day itself. Starts at sunset, okay? 2 p.m., do you know what we Israelis do? It's hot, still October. We take our pants down, we are just with our underpants, with our shirts, I mean it. And we go to sleep to kill some time, till the shofar will blow in the synagogues. I mean it, including soldiers. Not those in their post, but the soldiers in the rooms, they are only with their underpants, literally, when we are attacked by Syria.
Saying being caught with your pants down.
That's exactly being caught with the hands down. You do not give honor to the one who gave you the strength, okay, to win the 6 day war. I will spank you. A huge spank. Close to 3,000 casualties. Don't take it lightly, please. Today we are above 7 million Jews here in Israel, out of the 9.5 million. Guess what? Back then we were about 4 million, 3.5. Can you imagine, Timmy? Almost 3,000 people, friends. But nobody asked me how in the world did they surprise me. I mean, look, now we are not 15, 20 miles away down there, you know, the underdog, okay? We are now here, one of the soldiers who were in the Golani Brigade, who conquered, I think, Mount Hermon, yeah? He looked and he says, simple man, not educated, yeah? He said, pointed to the chocolate factory over there, you know, the army installation there, an army installation there, where they can see the wives, the women hanging their laundry 40 miles from here in Damascus. With their surveillance here, they can see what kind of coffee in the streets of Damascus. So he said, those are the eyes of the land. Okay? Nobody can conquer us anymore, right? When you don't give God the honor he deserves, guess what? When you are blinded spiritually, your spiritual blindness will affect your soul. Are you with me? Your intellect, the way you process things. Process which things? Do you think that they're stupid, that they're blinded with the bunkers here? They see into Damascus. Don't you think they saw the tanks are coming? Don't you think that they saw the artillery coming? They saw it, and they reported it to the government. Golda Meir, Moshe Dayan. And they interpret it as, they're just practicing. They will never dare to, you know? They saw what we did to them in 2 days. No, right. Well, they did attack. And they attacked in 3 arrowheads, okay? We are in the northern one. And here, let's speak about here, the Valley of Tears, Emek Abatha, where most of the windmills are, okay? You see over there, near, all the way to the stone quarry. This is where the fierce battles took place. Yeah. And are you ready for the shocking news? You know how many tanks the Israelis had? 148 about. You know against how many Syrian tanks with night vision? We did not have night vision. Syrian tanks with night vision, you know how many? Almost 1,000. Yeah. Adam, sweetie, let the others come. Beloved completely against all odds, again by God's mercies, we succeeded to block them here. Okay? While the other two arrowheads advanced almost seeing the Sea of Galilee. Yeah? My friends, this Emek Abacha, this Valley of Tears, saved us in that Yom Kippur War, the Yom Kippur War. So, high price, and still God had mercy on us. Miracles after miracles in the Day of Atonement, which lasted about 3 weeks. Beloved Moshe Dayan calls Golda Meir in the first days of the war, and he says, the third temple is about to fall. Of course, third temple, talking about Israel. We are going to be finished. Israel as a state is going to cease. Terrible situation. I told you almost 3,000 casualties. Triple it to understand how much it is heavy on the economic, because 3 times more than casualties, you have those who will need to be dependent, you know, crippled and without legs, without hands, okay? I mean, terrible concept. Give glory whom glory is due. And guess what? Did we learn since then? We made the Oslo Agreement with Satan incarnated into flesh, human flesh, Yasser Arafat, on the White House and Camp David. Yeah? We are continuing to make treaties with the devil. Remember, God says, I will cut your treaties, your covenant that you make with, in Isaiah, with the devil. Why are we so stupid? Spiritually, I mean. Because nothing is nearly the same, unfortunately. Till the very end, it's only a remnant, you ask me, which will believe in God. Please, don't romanticize scriptures. Don't wait for a great revival in Israel. Yeah, yeah, yeah. How many believed in Yeshua in the first century? A remnant. How many believed in Moses at Mount Sinai? A remnant. All the others, Hupla Hulad, around the Golden Calf. How many will be here to see, to witness Yeshua's glorious return? A remnant. Stop illusioning yourself. And guess what? Stop illusioning yourself that everyone who is called believer or a Christian will make it. It's not the ones who talk, it's the ones who walk the talk. Human beings are human beings. Flesh remains flesh. Dirty, yucky, pucky flesh. And the flesh always resists God. How do I know it? Bible tells. Read Romans 7. I do what I don't want to do. I don't do what I want to do. Oh, who will save me from this flesh? I will be. Thank God for Yeshua. If only if you stick with Him and if you clothe yourself with Him daily. Amen. Hallelujah. What's the time? I'm giving you the time now to